Hey everyone, welcome back to a new video. Today I'm going to share with you some of my must-read thriller book recommendations. I really love to read thrillers. Personally, I prefer to read thrillers during the summer, especially when I'm on summer holiday, but I think it's also very fitting to read during fall, of course, and a bit of more like the spooky season, even though that's not really my thing. But still, thrillers is a genre that I love very much. I do not claim to be like an expert on thrillers, but I do just love to read one every once in a while. And in this video, I have recommendations that are very suitable for people who want to begin with reading thrillers, but also some that are more for people who are already advanced thriller readers, if you can say it like that. Also, this is really only thrillers and crime novels. This is not a horror book recommendation because I really don't read horror books. So yeah, this is just thrillers, crime novels. If you want to read some horror, I suggest you find another video because I'm just not very good with that. This is purely thrillers. And for me, a thriller is a book where a crime is central to the story, and often the book is about solving the crime. So yeah, I think that's enough of an intro for now, and let's just get started. And then I'm going to tell you my must-read thriller book recommendations. So the first one I want to talk about is Then She Was Gone by Lisa Jewell. I want to start with this one because Then She Was Gone in particular, I think is very suitable for people to try out the thriller genre, so very suitable if you're a beginner with thrillers. This book tells the story of a woman named Laurel, and 10 years prior to the beginning of this book, her 15-year-old daughter Ellie went missing and the case was never solved, which of course would be very traumatic for any parent. But now in the present, Laurel meets a new man that she likes very much, but weirdly he has a daughter who reminds her very much of her own missing daughter. And the reason why I think this one in particular is very good for beginners with the thriller genre is because the story is quite simple. It is not a book full with details and different clues, and it's very much about a sort of simple crime, a missing girl, and then in the present it's about characters dealing with that. And yeah, I think it's more character focused than plot wise focused. Also, this book, normally with thrillers I don't really get all that emotional because I'm more like very busy with solving the mystery, but with this book I just felt so much for the characters. And yeah, I don't know, I just cared about them very quickly, and I think it was very well written in that way. That's also why this is one of my favorite thrillers. It is a page turner, but not in the sense that you would normally think with a thriller. But the story is so approachable, so easy to get into. It was a bit different from what I thought it would be, but in a very good way. My expectations weren't necessarily high when I first read this, but I was very pleasantly surprised. I think the writing style is very good. And it's just, it is a thriller story, but a very light one, if that makes sense. My next recommendation is a lot more well known, and that's mostly because there's a whole Netflix adaptation, but it is You by Caroline Kepnes. This book is about a man named Joe, and Joe is a stalker. At the beginning of the book, he meets a girl named Beck and he gets obsessed by her. And then this entire book, you see the story through Joe's eyes and all the creepy things that he does, with his obsession with Beck. That's also why it's called You, because it's told in the sort of perspective of I'm watching you, you're doing this. And this book is like creepy as hell. Again, there's a Netflix show which I've also watched and which I enjoyed very much, but the book is definitely even more creepier. I think the format of reading a book from the stalker's perspective is so interesting and so also terrifying. Like, not too much, but it's just, it gives you the creeps so much. And yeah, that's why I love this thriller very much. It does something different than most thrillers. It's so weird to follow Joe's train of thought and how he sort of has logical explanations of why he has to stalk back and why they are meant to be together, things like that. The writing style is very interesting. This is again quite a page turner. Like, all of these books are quite page turners, otherwise I wouldn't recommend them, but this is just a book that I would definitely recommend if you're looking for something very creepy. And I think what makes it even more creepier is that stuff like this happens, like men like Joe exist, or like people like Joe. It's just, this book gives you goosebumps. Again, I think it's quite approachable if you're not very familiar with the thriller genre, but it's a bit higher up if that makes sense, then she was gone. And yeah, I guess this is my ultimate recommendation if you're looking for those like creepy feelings. And then next up, pretty well known, but I would definitely recommend basically all the books by Karen Slaughter. I think she's one of the most well-known and popular thriller authors out there at the moment. She writes a lot. There are a lot of books that she's already published. So if you want to dive into her work, you have a lot of options to begin with. I do have like three recommendations to start with if you've never read Karen Slaughter before. The first one is The Good Daughter, which is a standalone book. So you can read it without like reading any other of her work, because there are some series in her sort of published works. The Good Daughter is about two sisters who have something very horrible happen to them when they are teenagers, and then the book mostly takes place when they are older, and then another crime in their hometown happens and it sort of relates back to their old crime. Yeah, it's sort of, with her books, it's hard to sort of explain what exactly is going on without spoiling stuff. You really have to experience it for yourself. But this is a very good one. I think my favorite of her. And then there's also Pretty Girls, which I listened to on audiobook. Also a very, very good one. Again, very creepy. And this book is about a woman whose sister went missing when they were young. So again, things with sisters. She writes that a lot, actually. And then lastly, this book, which is also a very good place to begin with, is Blindsided, because this is her very first book, like her very first thriller. And this is also the first book in a series which follows Dr. Sarah Linton and Chief of Police Jeffrey Tolliver, and they are sort of the main characters who solve the crimes within the books. This one in particular is about a woman who gets brutally murdered in a public bathroom. So yeah, that is the thing with Karen Slaughter that you definitely need to know. Her books are very, very brutal. Like, the crimes are really horrific and often described with much detail. That is something that you should prepare yourself for, and that is something that you really shouldn't mind when reading a thriller, because otherwise you won't like Karen Slaughter all that much. And I guess I would say that these are a bit more advanced thrillers. Of course, there are no rules, it doesn't have to be, but this is definitely a lot more gruesome than some of the other books on this list. And her books are definitely more about the mysteries and the clues and about solving everything that's going on. And I absolutely love her writing style, and I also love her characters and her eye for detail, because she does that very well. Yeah, and as I said before, the crimes are often very horrific, but that also makes it very interesting, at least for me. So that's why I like her books very much. I don't like all of them. I've read a couple now. Some are better, some are worse. As I said before, The Good Daughter and Pretty Girls are a few of my favorites. And those two are both standalones, and then this is the beginning of a series. And yeah, Karen Slaughter, she's popular for a reason. Also definitely someone that I can recommend. The next one I want to talk about is I Let You Go by Claire McIntosh. This book, it's very hard to give a synopsis, which is the case with most thrillers, but this book is about a woman named Jenna Gray, and she's involved in a very tragic accident. And because of this, she flies to the countryside and she tries to live a quiet life in peace, but her past seems to haunt her. So this is a book that I read quite a while ago, I think almost 3 years now, but I remember being so impressed with it. I don't know if I would be that impressed with it if I read it now, but I think I would still like it very much, and I still remember quite a bit of it. I think what I love about I Let You Go is that you don't know what you're getting into, and it's such an experience. Again, I think this book would be suitable more for thriller beginners, because it's again a book that is very approachable and very interesting, and you just get into the story straight away. And this book is weird, but in a very good way. You don't know where to look, if that makes sense. It's just, yeah, it's definitely an experience. It's really hard to explain, but this book is very, very interesting. Definitely not what I expected it to be. But just so, yeah, I don't know, a really fun and good thriller if you love thrillers. I hope that makes sense. Yeah. And again, this is a book with multiple points of view. Yeah, it's just, maybe this is not the best recommendation because I can't talk about it very much, but definitely read it. It's a very interesting and good experience if you love thrillers. My next recommendation is the entire Cormorant Strike series by Robert Gilbreth, which is a pen name of J.K. Rowling. It's actually written by J.K. Rowling. And this series, there are currently 4 books, The Cuckoo's Calling, The Silkworm, Career of Evil and Little White. And they all follow the detective Cormoran Strike and his assistant Robin. And every book has a crime that of course needs to be solved. But then it's also about Cormoran Strike's life and Robin's life and everything. So every book has its own story, but there's also a story continuing. And this is of course probably quite well known because J.K. Rowling wrote it. The Cormoran Strike series is again one of my favorites. This is a series that is very much about the mystery. Maybe I would describe it more as a detective mystery than like a true thriller, even though there are crimes and thrillery stuff happening. But these books are quite long. They're quite detailed. They're very much about solving the mystery. There are clues everywhere, so if you're paying attention, you can sort of solve it yourself. And I wouldn't say these books are slow, at least I don't find them so, but they're not like very fast-paced and action-packed like some of the other thrillers on this list are. So this is definitely a series. I wouldn't say that you need to be an advanced thriller reader, but you need to like longer books with more details that it's really about the mystery. I personally love that very much. I really love J.K. Rowling's writing style, and she really does know how to write a good mystery. And I love that you're on this journey with Cormoran Strike. I love all the characters. I love the setting because it's in London, so that's also something that I enjoy very much. I am very much invested in this series at the moment. Little White came out, I think, about last year, so it will probably be quite a while until there's a next book in the series, but until then you have four big books to begin with, and yeah, I just enjoy them. I love this story. This is definitely just, yeah, very story-based, even though there are also a lot of amazing characters. Yeah, it's just a bit longer, a bit more detailed, so keep that in mind when you pick this up. Then I also have Sadie by Courtney Summers, and this is a YA thriller, which is sort of unique because there aren't a lot of YA thrillers. But this one is there, and it was quite popular last year for a reason, because it's also quite good. Sadie is about a girl named Sadie. She's 19 years old and she tries to solve sort of the murder, well not sort of, she tries to solve the murder of her younger sister, which happened earlier. And now this book is being told in the form of a podcast. And it's about a journalist who is following her, trying to find out where she is because she just disappeared basically, to go on this sort of quest. This book is so amazing because again, it's pretty, I think, intense and pretty horrific at times, but it's still YA, so yeah, I don't know how to explain it. What I like about it most is the format, because it's told in the form of a podcast. Sometimes there are chapters from Sadie's point of view. This is definitely one that I would recommend the audiobook of, because the audiobook is amazing with especially like interviews and such, and all these different voice characters or like voice actors. It is intense, it is brutal, but also because of the format, quite easy to get through. It's quite a quick read, like not like a super quick read, but compared to some of the others on this list, it is quite quick and action-based, and it's definitely, you're on the journey of this sort of mystery with the journalist and with Sadie, and that's why you want to keep reading and you want to find out what happens. I love this book very much. It's very well written. I always love it when books do a different sort of format. And yeah, again, Sadie, a book that I love very much. Next up, I have The Perfect Girl by Gillie McMillan, which is, I think, a bit of a lesser known book. At least I haven't heard a lot of people talk about it. It's about a girl named Zoe, who is a very skilled pianist. And then this book is about a performance of her. And then the book tells you at the beginning that before it is midnight, her mother will be dead. And then there's also something like a crime involving Zoe from a couple of years ago. So you also get flashbacks to that. This is again a book that you really don't know what you're in for, and it's quite an experience. You just don't know what is happening until the very end, and there are different points of view. You don't know who to trust. You don't know what exactly is happening. You don't know what Zoe did a couple of years ago until quite a while into the book. I want to recommend this one because it's not that well known, or at least not that popular as some of the other titles. This is a book, I just had a good experience reading it. And apart from that, I would recommend it because of the same reasons as most of the other thrillers. It is not that long, but it's also not that short. It has quite an easy writing style, nothing too difficult. I guess sort of like a medium thriller. also one that I enjoy very much. And then I want to end this video with Big Little Lies by Leanne Moriarty. Again, a book with a very famous TV adaptation, which I've also watched. It's very good and I can definitely recommend that TV show as well. But this book is about a couple of the mothers whose children all go to the same school in the same class. And then there's also a crime. You're getting told at the beginning that there was a crime at a certain evening, but you don't know exactly what happened until the very end. So it's the story about mainly three different women. It's their backstories, it's about their lives, it's about their struggles. It's also about the sort of competitive stuff that's happening on the playground between all the mothers. You know, some mothers claim to know it better than others. It's definitely, this book is a lot more about the characters than it is about the story. Again, story is still important, but this is very much character based and also quite atmospheric. And I've read some other Leanne Moriarty books as well, also The Husband's Secret. But I think Big Little Lies is my favorite, purely because all the characters are so well written and you're sort of sucked into this story and you really feel like you're there. It feels so real somehow. And again, I think this is a book that is popular for a reason. Read the book, watch the TV show. I hope you will love it as well. So that was it for my thriller book recommendations. Some thrillers that I think are must reads. I hope this video has been useful to you, whether you're a more of an advanced thriller reader or like a beginner. I hope you can use this to sort of guide you if you don't know where to begin. But of course, again, I'm not an expert. These are just some of my favorite thrillers that I all really enjoyed. But this was it now for this video. If you like this video, please go subscribe or maybe give it a thumbs up, because as always, I would really appreciate that. And hopefully I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye!